person who is required to obey the law is entitled to a voice in its enactments, simple and perfect. Very significantly, the people in Worcester recognize the wide gap that exists between demanding rights and achieving them. Before the convention concluded, its leaders launched an organized movement. They appointed a leadership team. They created committees and appointed people to serve in these committees. They planned a second annual convention, which took place in Worcester in 1851 and was even larger than the first one. As we commemorate the Suffrage Centennial, there will likely be many conversations, and some began tonight, about racism that existed among many in the suffrage movement. Another reason to celebrate those in Worcester is that the Worcester Convention was radical on issues of gender and race. Lucy Stone and other leaders in Worcester were committed abolitionists, and they asserted the fundamental